So a few days ago, I read this tweet on Twitter. It said, and I quote, "People mean well, but I wish they'd stop telling me that my traumas made me who I am today. My resilience did that. I won't ever credit who and what tried to break me. All credit belongs to my ability to remove pieces that never should have been and finding ways to rebuild." I read it and it hit me like a ton of bricks that all my life I had been crediting the wrong factors here for my personal growth. I sat down and was like, wow, like I've been crediting my traumas, like all the past relationships I've been in, my friendships that didn't go well, everyone that betrayed me or just let me down. It wasn't it. The quote is so right on saying that my resilience did that, my own personal growth did that. So personal growth itself is like an obstinate little child. It's like, it keeps on wanting more and more. The more you feed to it, it keeps on wanting more and more. Like you give it something, they want more and everything. So the monster of wanting more just grows on and on. So you might be thinking there's no loophole to it, right? Like we should just like let obstinate children be, or just let them be, or just to feed the monster more and more. So I remember in my third grade or fourth, I don't really remember. I remember a teacher telling me that a human body is like a battery and how it needs to recharge again and again. It's limited to certain works at a certain time. Like you can't do everything all at once in a day. And that is why you also need naps and you need power naps and you need sleep to like recharge yourself. So if you overwork, your body reciprocates in form of tardiness or laziness or sometimes weakness. So the brain is very similar to the body. So if its job is not to overthink, and if you overdo that, so the brain reciprocates in form of self-depreciation, depression, anxiety, and the list goes on and on. So there's a term in psychology called the arbitrary inference. What it means is that it means drawing conclusions from little or no evidence at all. So arbitrarily inferencing, like making conclusions from little or no evidence at all, leads to feeling unloved, isolated, and it has like very detrimental effects on your brain. So that is what the brain reciprocates in form of having mental diseases. So I think the point that I'm trying to make here is your personal growth. Your personal growth is very much like that obstinate little child. The more you feed to it, the more it grows. The more you let it be, it just stays there. And sometimes it reciprocates in form of you feeling unloved, you feeling really bad things about yourself, and you feeling just isolated. So it's your personal growth is like that fish that you overfeed and then it dies. So the point also that I'm trying to make is that it is important for your self-growth to be there, to be well-fed, but it is to know that you don't overfeed it so that it grows into something that you don't want it to be. I remember my life being an average high school student, and I remember overachieving kids come up to me and like, just tell me and like boast about their achievements and everything. And I would just be like, okay. But the thing is, they also motivated me so much. They motivated me to be inspired and become into a really better person. So I was in a way really hopeful for the next day to like get out of my bed and be like, oh my God, I'm gonna get this bread. And like, I'm gonna go to school and like, give the answers to all of the questions that the teacher is asking and like get involved in everything that the school has to offer. So the very idea of fitting in constantly, the very idea of being hopeful for the next day to go to school and like answer the questions and everything. It did make me feel motivated, but at the end of the day, I also came home disappointed when I couldn't answer a math question. So there was always time when I felt I was preoccupied by quitting and like giving up. And like, so basically I realized that there was this pressure on me that was constantly telling me to grow, like over and over again, through people coming in and boasting about their achievements and telling about their like experiences and everything. It was always on me to like grow. So I think conclusively what I'm trying to say is that we should not let any doubts or fears or struggles or anything stop us from achieving what we want to achieve, or stop us from achieving the collection of dreams that we keep inside the pillow before we go to sleep. I want to say that you may think that you're infinitesimally small, you're inconsequential, but you're not insignificant. I just want to say that personal growth is personal growth. You grow personally, and you grow when you want to grow. You should not let anyone pull your limbs apart and force you to grow. Thank you.